From its introduction as a revolutionary guitar in 1954 to modern day, the Fender Stratocaster has been an iconic guitar in the music world. The guitar was developed and designed between 1952 and 1954, with the major players being Leo Fender, Bill Carson, George Fullerton, and Freddie Tavares. The original release of the 1954 Strat included several innovative features, including a distinctive body shape, a contoured back, a double cutaway, a three pickup design offering more range of tone, elongated horns. Most included a tremolo bar, and the guitar offered improved comfort whether you're sitting or standing. The Fender engineers spent countless hours in the field working with musicians to get the design right. Another impressive feature of the Stratocaster was the innovative upgrade of the tremolo bar from one of the current leaders of this technology, Bigsby. Fender integrated the vibrato arm into the bridge plate, which set a standard that is still used in the industry today. As you can see from the guitars depicted here, through the decades, Fender has continued to release a wide range of beautiful guitars. Even though a lot has changed since its inception, in many ways the Stratocaster is very similar to the one that was originally released back in 1954. On January 15, 1965, Fender was sold to CBS, Columbia Broadcasting Systems, which was preceded by a drop in sales for the company, including the sales of the Fender Stratocaster. Although Leo Fender remained on the board of the company, the CBS years are generally considered as a low point for the Fender line. The resurgence of the Stratocaster is credited with the arrival of Jimi Hendrix in the late 1960s. The Stratocaster's headstock has gone through a transition over the years, starting with a curvy design, which proceeded to get more pointed through the years, with the latest Strat reverting to a similar, if not the same, look as the 1954 version. The logo has also changed over the years. Some of the most notable changes include going from the original spaghetti logo, which can be seen on the 1954 headstock, to a transitional logo that can be seen on the 1975 headstock. Today's Stratocaster has gone back to the spaghetti logo as depicted by today's Stratocaster. The Fender Stratocaster Plus series was produced from 1987 to 1999. The Fender Custom Classic series was intended to be the best aspects of the vintage and modern Strats, and it was discontinued in 2008. The Fender Strat bridge cover, although seldom used by players, continued to be included as insisted by Leo Fender. Some players often discarded and even used as ashtrays. The Fender 1957 Strat introduced a neck with a more V-shaped feel with deeper body curves. In 1988, Fender released their first Stratocaster signature guitar for Eric Clapton. Musicians who have made the Strat famous include Jeff Beck, Eric Clapton, David Gilmour, Buddy Holly, Mark Knopfler, Robin Trower, Stevie Ray Vaughan, and the man Jimi Hendrix. And there are many, many more that are not included in this list. The most recent offerings of the Fender Stratocaster include the American Ultra Stratocaster and the American Ultra Stratocaster HSS, as seen here on Fender's website. The Fender Stratocaster continues to be an industry leader in the guitar world. Many major players today play a Stratocaster. 2020 has been a great year for Fender as they have sold more guitars than any other year in its history. It's clear that the Fender Stratocaster's rich history will live on for many years to come.